Lights Out was out there, that's when everything changed.
And did, in your mind, not for the better?
No. I got kind of scared because I realized now that, you know, that an impact had been created over the years, and I needed time to digest. You know, it was really strange thought that now what's going to happen now, you know? So, but after 2 months, I digested and we carried on until Strangers in the Night. That was when the thing happened with Phil, you know, hitting me, and I left the band.
Did that actually happen on stage?
No, it was just a billiard table, you know. Like, I told him that if he ever hit me, because he was fighting other people all the time, that I would leave the band, and he immediately checked it out, and I left.
And then went off to do, well, you went back to Scorpions for an album, did you?
Yeah, I went back for Love Drive, but there was a whole bunch of things going on. Well, I did Love Drive, and everybody was so happy with the whole outcome of the album, they asked me to join the band. And I didn't really think much. I didn't really look at my life at that point. I just kind of went from one hectic schedule into another hectic schedule. And then that's when I realized that, you know, I wasn't really... They started booking a tour, and I wasn't really happy doing it. Because I realized also that I had to, you know, practice and rehearse past material, which was done with Uli. And that was not... I did not want to write, but I didn't think, you know, ahead of time. I just thought, like, okay, I make an album with the Scorpions, and now we play, you know, the songs I play with the Scorpions. But I didn't realize that I had to practice all the old... By that time, they already had Tokyo Tapes, which was a live album, and there was plenty of material on there that I had to copy, and that was definitely not for me.
So, one of the reasons you left UFO, apart from Phil hitting you, was, you know, the stress was getting to you of that success and all the touring, and you end up with the Scorpions doing the same thing.
I wouldn't say I left them because of that. The UFO I left because of Phil, and the Scorpions I left because I realized that I didn't give myself enough time to really look at myself, what I wanted to do. So I kind of rejoined the Scorpions, how do you say, like, spontaneously, without looking. But when I realized that I had to copy all of these solos and songs, yeah, and stuff like that, that's when I decided, you know what, I think I want to do my own thing, because first, I don't want to join a band where I have to practice all of their existing leads and stuff like that.
You didn't want to learn somebody else's music?
No.
You want to do your own music, right, but not somebody else's.
And it didn't matter to me if others were more successful or not. The freedom to create for me was more.
So you did that one album, Love Drive, with them. Let's play a track off Love Drive.
Yeah, Love Drive.
The track itself.
Yeah.
So you left the Scorpions because partly you didn't want to play other people's music. You wanted to write your own.
Correct.
So you formed the Michael Schenker Group.
Exactly.
And now you were totally in charge of what you were doing.
I was totally enjoying being creative, starting things from kind of scratch.
So how did you put that first group together?
It was a long process. I mean, in between, I had another funny moment where I didn't really think, but I had Peter Mensch, who I was living with, who became the manager of AC/DC and Metallica and all of those bands, Def Leppard, he asked me if I wanted to audition for Aerosmith. And I said, yeah. And so we went over there, but Steven wasn't in the best shape. I wasn't really too good myself, but it didn't work out, but because Aerosmith basically broke up. But then I was ready to do my solo album, MSG, and so Peter said, why don't you use the drummer and the bass player from Aerosmith? I said, oh, that's a great idea. I went over to Boston. We started rehearsing for the first MSG album. And then Steven and Joe got back together. So Aerosmith was back in the picture. And then I bumped into Rush, who I knew from the days with UFO. I asked them if they were interested in doing my solo album, and they said yes, which was the drummer and the bass player, Geddy Lee and Neil Peart.
So the Aerosmith ones you lost again because they went back to Aerosmith. So you picked up Rush's instead.
And that fell apart. And the next was the Billy Sheehan and Danny Kamasi, who used to be the drummer with Montrose. And that was, and Gary Barden. And we rehearsed. And then I kind of got sick and that fell apart. And then I came back, and then we found Simon Phillips and Mo Forster, who were just recording with Jeff Beck. And we had Roger Glover doing the production, and that was the beginning of MSG, finally in the studio.